thank you so much for checking out today's video. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Trish and I'm with Just Dance. Today I'm going to be giving you tips to improve your smooth walks in, of course, the smooth dances. That would be like your waltz, your foxtrot, your Viennese waltz, and kind of tango, although tango's kind of in a boat of its own. So let's just stick to the three swing dances out of those. So waltz, foxtrot, and Viennese waltz. Let's go ahead and get to it. So, first of all, what is a smooth walk? A smooth walk is a step that we take in the smooth dances that have power, they travel, and it maintains contact with the floor. It looks like this. If I'm just gonna walk, I would have this like glide to my movement. And I do it backwards as well. Now, a lot of students struggle with this because they lose their balance. They're not quite sure where their weight should be within each step, and so they get something that looks a little bit like this. Or they step on the foot too soon. So let's go over my first tip, and that is make sure that you're in good postural alignment. That way, you're already balanced to begin with, and you're not having to rely on your partner to help hold you up. You can hold your own weight, and you can do this on your own with or without a partner. So postural alignment would be that your head is over your shoulders, your shoulders are stacked over your ribs, and your ribs stacked over your hips, thinking about elongating the spine and keeping a nice lengthy body through there. And then understanding that from here you can bend and straighten your knees without affecting your posture. So you don't want to bend at the waist or backwards or look down. All of those things, looking down at your feet, bending at the waist, it all will throw off your balance when you're dancing, especially when you're trying to take big steps. So make sure you have that good posture. My second tip for you is to understand your sending leg versus your moving leg. So for example, if we're going forward and I'm standing on my right foot and I'm about to step with my left foot, I want to make sure that as I prepare a step, my weight stays on my right leg. And all that I'm doing here is sending my left leg out in front of me without any weight. So if you watch this, I'm gonna lift my foot up so you can see that I'm clearly still on my right foot. I'm not shifting my spine with my moving leg. That is the biggest mistake that I see a lot of people make, is as soon as their moving leg goes, their body goes with it. And that's going to result in taking a really short step. So if you want to elongate your step so that you can really glide across the floor, make sure you, as you lower your weight and your spine, remain over your supporting leg, which is the right leg, the one you're standing on, as your other leg extends out to prepare for the step. Now this goes the same for a backward step. I could stand on my right leg again, and notice as I lower my leg, my moving leg extends behind me, and my weight stays forward over my supporting leg. So I'm almost in a lunge. Notice here I could pick my foot up and I'm still balanced. Again, most common mistake I see is people's heads start to go with their moving foot, resulting in stepping too soon. And a lot of times if you get stepped on by your partner, if you're going backwards, that's why. Because you stepped before they stepped and they ended up stepping on your foot. So try to work on staying over your standing leg longer as you prepare to take a step. Now, my third tip is on when to transfer the weight and how to do it. So let's go back to our forward walk. When we do our forward walk, again, we make sure we have our balance, we lower and extend the leg without weight. Now, transferring the weight, I'm going to drive. This is gonna give me my power. I'm gonna push off of this right leg. As my left leg moves a few more inches, notice I'm starting to move. My spine is in transition. My back heel has released. Oops, I did that too slow, I fell over. So notice that my back heel has released and I'm in my mid stride, where I'm balancing on the back of the front foot and the toe of the back foot. From here, ooh, this is hard. Okay, so from here, I'm going to then lower my front leg and I'm going to transition my weight onto the left foot As I do so, my back leg is going to slide in underneath me, so I'm back to my starting position with my feet together. That is the hardest part right there. If you can do the first two things, this will be your trickiest transition. Let me show you from this angle. So I lower and extend, then I start to push off the back foot as I drift forward to take a long step. Then I'm going to start to push more off that back leg. As I do, I'm gonna lower the front toe and start to bend my front knee to pull me onto the foot. And my other leg is going to collect nicely underneath. In this case, it would continue to swing through to take another step. I'll show you two steps in a row now. So I begin to lower and extend. I push off the back. I arrive on the front and I swing through back to my second tip, which was extending the leg without moving the spine. So there is a moment in time where your spine kind of stops traveling and your leg continues to travel. This goes the same for backwards. Lower and extend, push off of the back foot, begin to release the front toes as you take weight onto the back toes. And then as you lower that back heel, the free leg is going to swing underneath and behind to take that next step. So a couple of those look like this. Walk, whoops, let me try that again. And walk, walk. Walk. So there is a moment in time where my legs are swinging underneath me and my spine remains still, just for a split second to help your leg get into position. If you can master that, walking up and down your hallway or the floor or the grocery store, wherever you're dancing, this is going to make a tremendous difference in your smooth dancing. If you're able to do this on your own without a partner, with good balance and stride, you'll be able to dance with anyone, any size, and hold your own weight without having to rely on your partner for balance. So just to recap, we had three tips today. One is to make sure you're in good postural alignment. Two, to make sure that your weight is on the supporting leg so that your moving leg can prepare to step. And three, learning how to transition your weight from one foot to the next with a nice long extended glide. All right, so as always, these videos are meant to be a supplement to your training in the studio, but if you have any questions or suggestions for other videos, let us know in the comments below. And as always, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you can get notified for all the videos we create. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you soon.